Hello students, today we are going to determine the amount of each component of the ternary mixture of sulfuric acid, acetic acid and copper sulfate by conductometric titration. So during this titration, sulfuric acid being the strong acid will be neutralized first and conductance will be fall rapidly. Then the neutralization of acetic acid will take place, resulting in a slight increase in conductance, and finally the precipitation will take place where the copper ion, it will replace the sodium ions. Consequently, conductance decreases very slowly until the precipitation is complete. Thereafter, the conductance rises due to the excess of sodium hydroxide added. Thus, the titration curve will give three breaks. First corresponds to sulfuric acid, second corresponds to acetic acid, and third corresponds to copper sulfate. So for this experiment, we need a conductometric bridge, conductometric cell, then burette, standard sodium hydroxide, then sulfuric acid, copper sulfate solution, and acetic acid. We have calibrated the instrument by using 0.1 normal potassium chloride solution. For the titration of the mixture of sulfuric acid, acetic acid and copper sulfate, we are using standard sodium hydroxide solution. So we have filled the burette with standard sodium hydroxide solution. Now we are taking the mixture of sulfuric acid, acetic acid and copper sulfate. So for this, we have to take 5 ml of each of the compounds. So here, it is 5 ml sulfuric acid, 0.1 normal sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid, 0.1 normal sulfuric acid, it is prepared from concentrated sulfuric acid, volume by volume method. So here it is 5 ml. 0.1 normal sulfuric acid. Then we have to add 5 ml 0.1 normal acetic acid. We have to add 5 ml 0.1 normal copper sulfate solution. Now we have to add 85 ml of distilled water to this mixture. So here we have added 85 ml of distilled water. Now we are going to titrate it against standard sodium hydroxide solution. So we should be very careful. We have to record the conductance value. The machine is already calibrated with 0.1 normal potassium chloride solution. So the conductance is 2.1 millisiemen. Now we are adding 0.5 ml standard sodium hydroxide solution, and we are mixing the solution. Now we are recording the conductance. Then again, we have to add another 0.5 ml sodium hydroxide solution. And we have to record this value. Then again, another 0.5 ml sodium hydroxide. We have to mix the solution. Then we have to record the value. So in this way, we will repeat this process until there is sharp increase or decrease in the conductance of the solution. So after the completion of the experiment, we have to prepare an observation table like this, and we have to prepare a plot of conductance versus volume of sodium hydroxide. We will be get 3 breakpoints. First one corresponds to sulfuric acid, second one corresponds to acetic acid, and third one corresponds to copper sulfate. Then from V1N1 is equal to V2N2, with this formula we can determine the concentration of sulfuric acid, acetic acid, and copper sulfate.